Back in the mid-1950s, just about the time that Las Vegas was emerging as a national showbiz center, Sam Butera came up from New Orleans and hooked up with Louis Prima and Keeley Smith, and suddenly music became magic.
Down and down I go, round and round I go, in a spin, loving the spin I'm in, under the old black magic called love.
In a spin, loving the spin I'm in, under the old black magic called love.
Sam Butera will be the first to tell you that his life can be divided into two parts, the time before Las Vegas and the time since, with the dividing point going back to 1954, the year he joined Louis Prima and Keeley Smith. Suddenly he had everything he had ever wanted.
Louis Prima was an absolute genius. He was. His timing was impeccable. He read to our audience like nobody in the whole world. Keeley, great singer.
The falling leaves drift by my window. Those autumn leaves of red and gold. I see your lips, the summer kisses. The sunburned hands I used to hold. And soon I'll hear a winter song. But I miss you most of all, my darling. When autumn leaves start to fall, ba-ba-do-ba-do-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba-ba
every place we worked, we broke the record. I don't care whoever worked there prior to us. The record was broken, and it was incredible. People were lined up around the corner. We worked at the Shapery in Chicago, same thing in the dead of winter. Snowstorm, people standing up waiting to get in.
Since you went away, the days seem long, and soon I'll hear, oh, winter song. But I miss you most of all, my darling.
Back then, Louis Prima called the tunes and Butera did the arranging, but it was Keeley Smith who made it all seem so sexy and right and unforgettable, with her hot looks and cool voice, with that unflappable style of hers that melted the heart and made you yearn for things unattainable.
It wasn't just ordinary people lining up there in snowstorms and packing the houses. Some very important people used to come, right?
Oh, man, everybody came. Sammy did it, Frank Sinatra, Dean Martin, Johnny Carson used to come on stage and play drums, Elizabeth Taylor.
For a long time, it was much more than music and business. It was family.
You were thinking there for a while that it was just going to go on forever?
Well, I've always been a believer in this. Nothing is forever. Nothing is forever. But I didn't think that they would get a divorce because they two beautiful daughters and it seemed so happy to me, you know, and all of a sudden, bam.
The divorce broke up the act. Sam Butera went with Louis Prima. Keeley Smith went off on her own. But Louis Prima never recovered.
So he comes to you right out of court, right? And he says what?
Well, he just shake his head. He was crying like a baby. He didn't want you to talk about it anymore. And after that, he never would say Keeley's name for a long time. He used to call her Bangs, you know, because she wore had the bangs. He would never even say her name for the longest time. I guess it was bitter, you know.
That last night when you and Louis and Keeley were up there on the stage,
yeah.
And you knew that it was like the last night, right?
Yeah.
Were you pouring a little more of your heart out or a little less of your heart out?
It was hard to play. It was a chore. You just went through the motions. And the people in the audience knew it.
What do you mean they knew it?
They knew the divorce was
coming.
Yeah, and that was the last night. They knew it. Hard.
So what did you open with that night?
Oh, gee, what's the usual, when you're smiling.
When you're smiling?
Yeah. That was a theme song then.
How does that go?
When you're smiling, the whole world smiles with you. When you're laughing, The sun comes shining through. Good tune.
It's a great tune. Yeah. It's a great tune. And Keeley was still deadpan?
Oh, yeah. More than ever. More than ever that night, I guess.
I never knew how much I love you. I never knew how much I care. But when you put your arms around me, I get a feeling that's so hard to bear. You give me fever when you kiss me, fever when you hold me tight.
Fever!
Fever in the morning, fever all through the night.
In 1975, Louis Prima's voice started to go. Doctors diagnosed a brain tumor. Not long thereafter, he suffered a stroke that kept him in a coma for 3 years. On August 24, 1978, he died of pneumonia. Sam Butera refused to let the music die with him.
I'm just a gigolo.
Gigolo.
Everywhere I go.
Gigolo.
People know the part I'm playing.
Gigolo, gigolo, gigolo.
Pay for every dance.
Gigolo.
Selling each romance.
Gigolo.
Martinez. What they say,
gigolo, gigolo, gigolo.
That there will come a day when youth will pass away. What will they say about me?
When the end comes, I know they'll say just a gigolo.
Life goes on without me, cause I...
Now I know that some of you are saying that you've heard the song before, that it's something that David Lee Roth made popular a few years ago. Well, that's not quite true. Sam Butera did the arrangement over 35 years ago and still sings it to this day in a way that few can hope to copy, much less improve.
Only want some sweet mama, yes. Take a chance with me, cause I ain't so bad.
I'm Just a Gigolo was one of Louis Prima's favorites. He often opened the show with it. Sam Butera sings it every night when he goes on stage at the Tropicana Casino in Las Vegas, or wherever else he happens to be performing in the world. He sings that one and all the great ones that Louis Prima and Keeley Smith and he made so immortal.
I was with Louis Prima, folks, for 23 years. I was with Louis Prima longer than all of his wives. What we're gonna do for you now is my favorite songs I so enjoyed listening to Louis sing each evening. And maybe one or two you might remember, hopefully. Let's see how many you remember, all right? Now many long years ago, a fella named Robin Hood, he used to rob the rich most every chance he could.
He shouldn't get wrong because he was real square. With his trusty bow and arrow, he could pop your head.
Oh, Marie.
Oh, Marie.
Oh, Marie.
Oh, Marie.
In your arms, I'm longing to be.
Longing to be.
Ah, baby.
Baby.
Tell me you love me.
Tell me you love me.
Oh, Marie.
Oh, Marie.
Come here, Sam. Come here, boy. Where money? Where money?
Another bachata. Another bachata good day.
Bachata good day. Oh, what happened? You can't play an Italian.
Bachata good day. What the hell is the matter? Can't you play Sicilian?
When the saints,
when the saints,
go marching in,
go marching in.
I want to be there.
I want to be there.
On Bourbon Street.
On Bourbon Street.
When the saints go marching in.
It's been more than 28 years since Keeley Smith and Louis Prima parted company, and more than 12 years since Prima's death. But for Sam Butera, little has happened to take away the grief of it all, and no matter how often Butera smiles, the memory of what once was is as vivid as ever. Was there anything that you ever wanted to say to him or to her that you never said? Honestly. Don't fake me out.
Well,
honestly.
Well, you see, I admired both of them a great deal. And I never did really tell Keeley how great she sang. Because it wasn't my thing. She knew that I loved the way she sang. And Louis, what can you tell him? And I loved him. Thank you.
every night of the week when Sam Butera isn't out of town, he and his band do three sets at the Tropicana Casino and Hotel on the Vegas Strip. And every time he steps up on that stage, it's like his first opening night ever. And everything that's dark and disturbing vanishes the moment he flashes his irrepressible smile. And when I see him up there, still in his prime, when I hear the music of his horn and the melody of his voice, I know that you can only be that good when it comes straight from the heart.
When you're smiling, keep on smiling, boy, 'cause the whole world smiles, whole world smiles, whole world smiles, man. I hope you like that, folks.
She was that way in the courtroom when her daughter testified. She was also extremely manipulative when testifying herself in front of the jury. She tried to present herself in a completely different light than the other two were showing. Mm-hmm. In other words, Pam and Belinda described her one way, mm-hmm. and told the story in a way that really showed Janine masterminded the whole crime. But Janine, of course, testified she only wanted them to scare the little girl. She didn't really want them to do the beating. Mm-hmm. So she was trying to manipulate the jury. And I think she just talked them into it.
How would you characterize Janine as a mom or as a person?
I thought Janine Cootie was an extremely poor example of a parent. She took her daughter along with the other two when they went to beat up Sherry Drum. She took her daughter along when she dressed the other two up and provided them costumes. And she took her along when she showed the other two who the little girl was they were to beat up. And she took her little girl to dinner the next night when she and Pam Mays were bragging to a third witness about how they had pounded Sherry. Mm.